So we see a lot of different Native contexts. There are different political contexts, different legal rights that Indigenous communities have and share with each other and sometimes don't have. And I think that the implications for nation building are important to take account of these differences. These differences matter for what can and cannot be done and how costly it is and how uncertain the policies will be after they're implemented. I think that overall, the framework of nation building applies generally in a lot of contexts. And so when we talk about culture and institutions and sovereignty, it might be that lawyers would differ on the term sovereignty or the implementation details of what institutions would be required differ from place to place. But my general sense after working on these issues for 30 years is that there's really a framework in place that Indigenous communities can use. And when we see these differences, the Indigenous communities, the tribes and First Nations have adapted and they're pushing forward. I think that when we look at, say, some of the really amazing tribes that have come a long way in the lower 48 states of the United States, for example, we see successful casinos, we see successful programs and so on, and we maybe have to think twice to remember that sometimes these communities asked permission to get a phone line from the Bureau of Indian Affairs 40 years ago. Or maybe were told by the states, no, you can't do that. And we all live in history and in time, and when we think of the tribes today having lots and lots of powers and lots of institutions that take advantage of those powers, they didn't always have them.